In the spotlight, the new Bravo reality show, Game of Crowns, premieres this weekend with two Rhode Islanders among the cast. The show follows six pageant wives and explores the world of the Mrs. Circuit. Buckle up and take a look.
On stage, it's all about world peace.
You are an advocate for anti-bullying.
Absolutely. But off stage, it can be war.
Why is that funny?
Her husband threatened Susanna's husband's life.
What?
A restraining order?
Huge smear on my reputation.
I'm starting to get calls from people asking me if I'm okay.
You tell me I threatened to kill you, and that's a misunderstanding?
What the hell do you need a gun at a pageant for?
Don't use your little fake PR agency when your little fake voice comes out and the hands start doing the quotation.
All right, so let the games begin, let the drama begin. Here this morning are two of the local ladies starring in the new series Game of Crowns, Lynn and Susanna. Good morning.
Good morning.
Okay, I gotta ask you. We played that clip, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you sit there and do you see it and go, oh my God? Do you remember saying some of the things? Do you ever freak out after you've seen the episodes going, oh my God, why did, I mean, me sitting here, I'll say things some days, and I'm
right.
Like, oh my God, why did I say that?
I know.
That? And it's gone.
Exactly.
But this is gonna be all over the country.
Yes, yeah. Absolutely. You know, it's fun. It's mindless television. It's reality TV. I've had a little stint in that before.
That's okay. That's all right.
And honestly, it's really, you know, sometimes you film for 15 hours a day, and I can't always be pageant perfect. 15 hours a day.
Right, speaking of pageant perfect, this was one of the quotes I read this morning online. It says, on stage, it's all about world peace.
I take credit for that.
But off stage, now this is perfect. Off stage, it is war. Mm-hmm. Is that true?
That's true.
Is it really?
Pageant day, yeah, I mean, you're there. It's a competition. It's a baseball game. It's a softball game. You know, you're there to win, and you're there to compete. Mm-hmm. So there's a lot that goes along with that.
But does it make it tough? If I know you're going to compete. I know you want to win. But when there's someone who you're very close to, does it make it tough to really want to go in and just...
No, if you have a true friendship, we have a true friendship.
Right.
We're really best friends, and we actually enjoy it. We're leaving in about a week and a half to go to Mrs. United States.
Okay.
Susanna's Mrs. Rhode Island, United States. I'm Mrs. Massachusetts.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll compete against each other in the biggest, most prestigious pageant in the country to win a national title. And we're all excited. We share clothes. We share a makeup artist. We share Susanna's daughter's a stylist. We share a hairstylist. We help each other. But I think it's the frenemies, right? The frenemies.
It's fun, right?
That's
You're not real friends, then it gets dicey off the stage. But when you have a true friendship and it's a hobby the two of you do together,
right?
Then the friendship lasts.
Have you gotten used to? You've already shot this season, correct?
Yes, uh-huh. We have.
Have you gotten used to having the cameras around? Or can you ignore them? Because I've heard other people say they ignore them.
Yeah, a while, you just don't even know they're there because you have to carry on with an everyday life. I'm a mom of two kids, and, you know, Lynn is a mom as well. So eventually, you know, you go back to real life, and our husbands are like, listen.
All right, speaking of husbands, what did the husbands say when you ladies got signed up for the show?
Well, you know, it always seems like no big deal at the
Apparently
time.
Apparently, you won.
Right, exactly. You know, I think it's like anything. You know, they take it with a grain of salt. My husband buys into everything that I do. That's
right.
Why I married him.
Yeah.
And I think it's great. And I think, you know, the husbands come on stage. They have to walk us on stage at these pageants anyways. So now he's just walking me on national TV.
I think it wasn't a big stretch for me because I'm the CEO of Optics. So
right.
One of the biggest things that we do at my company is celebrity product placement. And we deal with a lot of red carpet events and award shows. And we put sunglasses on a lot of great celebrities.
So he's been around it before.
He's been around it. He hasn't been in front of it.
Right.
He's sort of watched it from the side. And he's an ophthalmologist. And I have the retail luxury store, you know, within the same building. So he's watched it. And he's obviously, you know, been around it. But for him to be in front of the cameras, that was new. But as far as the whole show thing, that wasn't too big.
We can't talk to our husbands about butt glue.
That's what I was going to say.
And preparation.
Okay, that's what I was going to say. Okay, so we have some secrets of the trade here.
We might make you try something on.
All right, let's go ahead. Okay.
Okay, so... Well, I'll let you do the butt glue, but I'll do the cuccini.
Right, okay. Explain butt glue. Mm-hmm.
Butt glue, you can actually buy at a sporting goods store.
Okay.
Okay?
Yep.
So this basically glues down your bathing suit, so as you're walking, there is no...
Your butt's not hanging.
Exactly.
Got it.
Yep. So that's pretty much what this is. Standard norm can be used for a lot of other things. Even
I'm
on the bottom
you.
Of your shoes so you don't slip on
right.
stage.
Okay.
Now
so,
I'm buckling up. Here we go.
So
okay.
Now here's the
All right, here we go.
Here. Okay.
Yep.
You're wearing a teeny tiny swimsuit. You want the best look at your body for the judges to see if you're physically fit.
Gotcha.
Sometimes things in a tight swimsuit down below can show off some stuff you're not
proud of.
Right.
Being camel toe. Oh, my God, okay. I said it. Right. Camel toe. So, the Cuccini.
Okay.
Is your best friend if you are a woman wearing a tight swimsuit on stage. And mind you, the judges are below and you're up on a stage. So those judges are looking up potentially at things people wouldn't usually see if you were standing at eye height. So
you've got the...
This is the Cuccini.
There you go.
There it is.
Their slogan is, our lips are sealed.
I hate to cut you off. I got you. You guys are going to be sticking around. We're going to talk more about you because later in the show, Lynn is going to fill us in on the hottest sunglass trends for summer from her company, Optics.
From runway to railway, we are popping on the shades for summer, and Game of Thrones stars Lynn is here. I know that she mentioned earlier in the show that she is the CEO and founder of Optics, so you are here to share your expertise. And Susanna, we couldn't leave you out of this. You have to model
Who better than Mrs. Rhode Island to model
sunglasses?
Thank you. And our nationals in Vegas, so we'll need lots of these.
Yes, we will.
You actually have a lot of famous people modeling your shades.
I do. Probably my favorite client is Juliana Rancic. She's a sweetheart. She actually just got the Chanel that Susanna's wearing in black when we were down at the Miss USA pageant. We're corporate sponsors to Donald Trump's Miss USA.
Wow.
And we brought a selection. We had a beautiful pool party for all the delegates, and they loved the sunglasses.
Okay, so what should we look for? These are, of course, hot things that are coming up for the summer.
Yeah. So the big trend right now is the flash lens. Ray-Ban has gone through the roof, not just for their aviator. These are called flash lens. And these would be perfect with your dress, seriously.
What does that mean when you're saying flash lens?
The flash lens is an ultra-reflective mirror lens, and they're done in beautiful colors. Those are so perfect with your dress.
Great. They match perfectly.
I own those in three colors. I try not to pull too much stuff off the floor, but those I love. And then Ray-Ban just did velvet. This is actually velvet.
So look at the texture that you can make on the shades there. You also have some different additives, too. I've noticed a lot.
These are G Jewels. My daughter is the designer and founder of this line. This line is manufactured by Susanna at Susanna's factory. Julia drew up all the designs. You know, here's our little G Jewels tag here. And they all have a different name. And we launched together. Julia launched her sunglasses with Bella's clothing line, Bella, Susanna's daughter.
In New York,
at New York Fashion Week.
Style Week as well.
And what a great collaboration.
Yeah. And so these are for little fashionistas.
Yeah. All right, but we have to get to another famous fashionista who is soon to be going home with a pair of these.
Those are getting shipped out to Kelly Osbourne. Kelly Osbourne likes funky stuff. We gave her a crazy cat eye Tom Ford recently she loved. Mm-hmm. She has a huge Dolce & Gabbana with all 3D flowers, and she loves the unusual, and she's gorgeous.
These are kind of unusual. They almost look like eyebrows attached to
Kelly's also getting these. These are being sent out to Kelly, and another famous client has these. The current Miss Universe, Gabriella Isler, has these in two colors.
Yeah. I got to talk about the ones that you just threw
on. Those are Dita.
Those are Dita. I love the cat eye. Mm-hmm. I think it's really in, right?
It is. Those are called the Magnifique, and that comes in a variety of colors, but I'm in love with the pink. If you are going to do that sunglass, go all the way, go crazy, do it all out, and do it in hot pink.
Nice and bright and bold. And I know a lot of people come to Optics for not just sunglasses, but regular glasses.
Right.
But for either, you suggest a fitting.
I do. I always suggest a fitting because... It's great. You can buy sunglasses anywhere, obviously, but when you have personal attention, and especially if it's for a prescription glass, a new trend is people are coming in for nerd glasses. These are non-prescription with the clear as an accessory, and this happens to be the Chanel Bijou. Now, if glasses don't fit right, they can slip down your nose, especially if they're prescription, or if they're too tight, they levitate. If it's too tight here, it just levitates. It makes me crazy when I know it's terrible. It's a pet peeve. People don't have them. So when you come to Optics, we fit them to your face.
That's
we can
so
bend
nice
the temples. We can scrunch them in, and they fit perfect. Susanna has a Cartier on that both she and I own. the Panther, and that's their signature piece. That's one of their highest-end pieces, and that is gorgeous. And we actually both
have those. Do you wear a lot of the Optics shades on Game of Thrones?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, we are. Now we're rocking these.
We're going to have to keep our eyes peeled for sure. And I love the fact, too, like you said, if they fit right, you're both busy women, you're moms, you're on the go, you're bending down and picking stuff up, you're moving around. You don't want your shades to fall off your face, especially when they're that nice, too.
But, I mean, they're so much fun.
I'm going to try these on before Kelly gets a hold of them. All right, if you want more information about Optics or Game of Thrones, of course, make sure you tune in, too. You can head on over to the Roadshow page, WPRI.com.